Dance Your Heart on Fire podcast episode number 42.
What did you like the most about dancing with her?
I think the thing that made me feel that I would like to have her as my partner was the connection that we had and how musical she is. It's very important for a girl to not only to follow but also to express and to add some things from herself. And the style of dance, and she does that very, very well. And she also improving every time we dance.
So. Nice.
Welcome to the Dance Your Heart on Fire podcast, the podcast dedicated to inspiring dancers worldwide whose hearts have been touched by music and dance. The universal language of dance and music is spoken by many of us throughout the world. We want to motivate the dancer in you by sharing stories, insights, and ideas to enhance your journey. Join us now with your host, Charles Ogar.
Hello, hello everyone. This is Charles with the Dance Your Heart on Fire podcast, and we're coming at you with another episode. And this week, we are interviewing a pretty cool guy. I've had my eye on this guy probably since I started dancing kizomba, because I started dancing kizomba in 2012, probably around the same time this guy started dancing, and I couldn't get over the fact like how young he was. I was like, man, this guy is young, and then he's so good at kizomba. Like, what's going on with this guy? So I've watched his videos. I think we shared a few messages back and forth and like shared some songs and stuff like that on Facebook. And not too long ago, I was like, hey, let me go ahead and interview this guy, because I think he put out like another video of you dancing with Sara Lopez or something like that. I'm like, I wanted to know more about this guy's story. So I was able to reach out to him, and he said yes. So he's here on the podcast today. We have Mr. Wojtek Pazur. How are you doing today?
Hello, I'm fine. Thank you for having me here.
Not a problem. So I'll let you say a little bit of an introduction to your, I guess, what you do today, and then we'll get started into your history.
So yes, my name is Wojtek, as you said. I'm 18 years old.
18. Wow. 18.
I'll be soon 19, actually. I am in my last year of high school right now. I come from Lublin, Poland.
Mm-hmm. All right. And you said you're in your last year of high school. And then how old were you when you started dancing kizomba?
I started dancing in 2010.
Mm-hmm.
I was 12 back then. I remember it all started when I went to visit my sister in summer, and she was dancing salsa. She wanted to go to a salsa party, and she had me under her wings. Obviously, she had to take care of me, so she decided to teach me some few basic steps and just take me to the party. And I remember it was the same day she taught me the basic steps and she took me for a party. I remember I already danced with 14 girls on my first party.
So you're 12 years old, your sister showed you some steps, you said you danced with 14 different girls?
Yes.
So how was that for you? I mean, at 12 year old, were you still kind of afraid of girls or?
Not really. I think I was the main problem was that I was pretty short and I had to literally jump to turn them, but they have fun with it. So it was okay.
I got you. So did you have like any desire? Did you see any kind of salsa dancing before your sister took you to go salsa dance? Like, did your parents dance or anything like that?
No, but my sister danced. I think she showed me something before. I saw her dancing, but it's been a while until she actually decided to teach me.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think I would like it this much, but I got into it a lot, and I started to to dance and go to some, I went to some classes.
Mm-hmm.
I also learned bachata.
Mm-hmm.
It was Cuban salsa and bachata and then salsa Los Angeles.
Okay, so the linear salsa.
Yes.
Okay, so your sister is the one that kind of first introduced you to dance, but did you have like any other friends? Like what were the other boys doing at 12 years old, 13 years old, 14 years old? Is it none common for them to dance?
No, none of my friends danced, so I was kind of different at this point.
Mm-hmm. And did that bother you, or did you just kind of accept it because you really like to dance, or how was that feeling?
I like to dance, and no one had any problem with that.
And your parents were supportive of it as well?
Yes, they were. They still are.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. That's really awesome that you have their support. So I guess from the beginning, you can kind of feel that you're different from the rest of your friends in school and things like that, you know?
Yes.
Okay, so you're dancing Cuban salsa and then bachata, and then you said you did some LA-style salsa. When did kizomba come?
2 years later. It was the same community that danced all the dances, salsa, bachata, and kizomba. I wanted to learn kizomba before because I seen it and I liked it, but I was too short to actually dance kizomba.
Ah.
So it started in summer 2012.
Mm-hmm.
I mainly at first I went to some classes. There was one teacher in my city,
mm-hmm.
and also I was intensely looking at some videos on YouTube.
Okay, what kind of videos? Who were you watching back then?
Oh, that was Albert Time. He was my inspiration.
Mm-hmm. He seems to be the inspiration for a lot of people, myself included. So you're watching Al Beer, and you had an instructor in your city that was teaching, and you went to go try out his classes?
Yes, and I was going to the course for some time, mm-hmm. and then I started to go to the first festival.
Mm-hmm.
It was, I'm not sure, I think it was 1 month after I started dancing kizomba, I went to Bachatura Festival in Warsaw and took first workshops, went to first the full kizomba parties, because in my city the parties were mixed.
Mm-hmm.
It was salsa, bachata, and kizomba together and not mainly kizomba. So I was really happy that I could dance kizomba all night at the festival.
Mm-hmm. And what happened after that? Did you get hooked? Did you get addicted?
Yes, I get so addicted. I kept dancing. I kept improving.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to go to as many festivals as I want to. I couldn't go to as many as I want to because I was still young.
Mm-hmm.
And that was back then. I had to travel with my sister.
Mm-hmm.
But like year after or already I think I kind of started to travel alone.
Mm-hmm.
And how I started to started teaching, it was 2 years after I started this Zumba. It started with Sarah, actually.
Mm-hmm. Sarah Lopez.
Yes, he came to Warsaw for a festival in 2014, I think.
So just to let our listeners know, there was this one viral video with you dancing with Sarah Lopez from back in 2014 that was really, really, I guess a lot of people shared it. There were a lot of likes and comments and things like that. So I guess that's how you kind of like broke out a little bit.
Yeah, that was the first time also I danced with her.
That was the first time you danced with her? Yes, okay, wow.
I was so nervous. It was after her workshops. I just wanted to dance with her. She was standing. There was a break, so mm-hmm. there was a music. So I just asked her if I could dance with her.
Mm-hmm.
And my friend took a video.
Mm-hmm.
And then after the dance, she asked me if I could assist her on Tarachinia workshops because
oh,
she
wow.
was... she was alone. It was after she stopped dancing with Albion.
Mm-hmm. So how was the experience of assisting Sarah in the workshops? So you said you're nervous dancing with her. Now you're teaching with her. How was that?
Yeah, that was pretty. I was really nervous. I wasn't really teaching. She was teaching, and she just took me to do a demonstration.
Mm-hmm.
But it was the whole experience was really exciting.
So that was your first experience with teaching, and then what happened after that? Did people start asking you to teach after that, or did you decide to teach?
There was one guy that came up to me after she saw me dancing with Sarah and told me that I should start teaching,
mm-hmm.
because I have some potential.
Mm-hmm.
And he invited me to the first workshop that was in Krakow. That's a different city in Poland.
Mm-hmm.
So I think around 2 months later. So I went, and that was my first teaching experience. I remember it was two days in a row, two mm-hmm. workshops. I remember after first, I kind of lost my voice because I wasn't used to talk so much and so loudly.
For everybody to hear you.
Yeah, so after the first day, I kind of lost my voice, so it was harder to do it the second day, but I enjoyed it. I remember back then I was really, really shy also, so it wasn't easy for me to speak in front of so many people.
How many people were there?
Around 20, maybe. Gotcha. 30 or something like this.
Okay, so that was like a festival or a weekender in a different city.
Yes.
I saw in your bio that you're also teaching in your hometown, yes?
Yes, I was teaching in my salsa school.
Mm-hmm.
That's when I also started to dance kizomba, mm-hmm. in general. It was 2014 also, mm-hmm. after the first workshops, I started to give the regular course.
Nice, nice, nice. So what would you say you enjoy about teaching kizomba the most?
I think it's always good to spread the kizomba to people who don't dance,
mm-hmm.
and people who dance also to show new things.
Mm-hmm.
And when I was attending kizomba workshops, I really admired the teachers and mm-hmm. how they do everything and how they are. They can explain and teach their things, and I also heard some. For me, it was always important to be musical during dancing, and that was the thing that I focused on
mm-hmm.
while teaching.
Do you teach musicality a lot when you teach?
I always mention that when I teach some routine,
mm-hmm.
I say that you don't have to do it always in the same tempo.
Similar, yeah, for sure.
You can, it depends on music. You can change it. You can, you don't have to rush. You don't have to just do the routine, but use the steps from the routine in your dance, depending on the music.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome. That's awesome. Let's take a quick moment to thank our sponsors. Have you been looking to level up your kizomba, but you don't have the local instructors to take you there? Are you looking for something concrete to practice with your kizomba partner? Or are you looking for kizomba lessons that you can take on your schedule and the comfort of your home? If you answered yes to any of these questions, look no further. LearnToKiz.com is what you need. Progressive, step-by-step lessons that you can take at your pace in the comfort of your home or anywhere with a solid internet connection on your PC, Mac, or any smartphone. New videos are added every month. You can try this awesome resource out 30 days free at LearnToKiz.com/podcast. After the 30 days free, it's only a low $15 per month. But again, the special offer for the Dance Your Heart on Fire listeners, 30 days free at learntokiz.com/podcast. You won't find this offer anywhere else. learntokiz.com/podcast. And now back to our show. So before, I want to take a quick break from Kizomba and talk about you in school. So you're getting more and more known for your Kizomba, but at the same time, you're in school at the same time. I'm curious to know, like, where do you see yourself in 5 years, 10 years? Are you going to study something in the university, or are you going to try to dance more like Albier and like travel to different festivals and things like that? Have you thought about that?
I am planning to go to university mm-hmm. after I finish high school this year, but I don't want to stop teaching and traveling. I want to try to mix those two things together. Mm-hmm. So because I know that teaching cannot be like forever. Also, something For sure. can happen to me, like injury, mm-hmm. and it's always good to have some kind of a backup.
Yes, definitely. What are you going to study in the university?
English and Chinese languages.
Okay. So you want to be an instructor, or do you want to
I think something like with translations.
Okay. I got you. How many languages do you speak now?
English, a little bit of Spanish from school. Mm-hmm. I also been learning Thai.
Okay.
For a bit.
Nice.
And a bit of Italian because I traveled for the competition, so and I kind of
picked up a little bit.
Yes.
All right. So that's actually what I want to talk about with you next. I noticed I was watching you on Facebook in 2015, and I noticed that you entered a competition in Italy. So can you tell us how that experience went for you?
Yes. Also, after the episode with Sarah Lopez, the video, there was one girl that wrote to me on Facebook, Federica. She invited me to the competition with her, even though we didn't dance before together.
I got
but,
you.
Yes, but I went there and we tried it out together, and we really got the connection. We really enjoyed dancing together, so we took the competition and we took some. I think it was elimination competition. Mm-hmm. We took the first place, so we had the opportunity to go to semifinals, mm-hmm. and then we went to finals.
Okay, awesome. And I think in the bio says you guys got to third place overall. Yeah,
third place in Italy. Yes, it was Kizomba Italia Cup competition, mm-hmm. and for these competitions I had to travel a lot and dance a lot in Italy, mm-hmm. and I think this Italian episode was one that that helped me improve my dancing the most, because mm-hmm. Italian kizomba community was really big and really more advanced than in Poland. Mm-hmm. That's why I had a lot of opportunities to dance. Also, I had more motivation to. Became motivation to improve in order to win the competition. Mm-hmm. So I know what things I had to focus on, like musicality, like technique. Mm-hmm. And it was also a good experience because I had to work on my dealing with like stress.
Yeah, like pressure.
Yeah, pressure, nesting and pressure, because during the competition, it's improvisation. Mm-hmm. And usually you don't even know the music, so you have to just dance like you were dancing on a party.
Yeah, for sure.
And when the pressure and the stress comes in, it's much harder to dance like you would actually dance well in the party. Mm-hmm.
So what would you say during the competition, what was one of the techniques that you focused on the most that helped you out the most?
The techniques? Mm-hmm.
Was there something in particular that you found that you needed to do better?
I think there was a time that I had to improve my kizomba walking. Mm. I don't know how to.
No,
how
I to get you. So just the overall, the way that you walk.
The way I walk, that I do steps to mm-hmm. to make them look better.
Mm-hmm.
And not to rush into music also.
Yeah, that makes sense.
You take time to just do one step on one beat, not before, and not rush on the music.
Nice. So I was seeing here that you've already started to travel, but the person that you're traveling with now is Marcia.
Marisha. Yes, she's from Warsaw. She's also from Poland, but different city. I met her in February last year. Mm-hmm. She was in Berlin at the festival in Berlin.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided to try to teach together.
Mm-hmm.
We already had three festivals, three events we've mm-hmm. been together.
And how old is she?
She's 21.
Okay, so she's a little bit older than you. And how's that going?
But I'm used to it. Like, from the beginning, I was always the youngest, and the age differences were huge.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, now 18 and 21 is actually nothing for me.
Yeah, I hear you. What did you like the most about dancing with her?
I think the thing that made me feel that I would like to have her as my partner was the connection that we had, mm-hmm. and how musical she is.
Mm.
It's very important for a girl to not only to follow, but also to express and to add some things from herself,
mm-hmm.
depending on the style of dance. And she does that very, very well. And she also improving every time we dance. So.
Nice. Okay, awesome. And so you guys are having some dates coming up to go and travel in different places, which is awesome. And it's awesome that you're going to be focusing on your studies with the university and then also trying to dance full time as well. Yeah?
Yeah, that's what I hope to manage.
Definitely. Okay, so I have three more questions for you to kind of wrap up the podcast here, and I appreciate you everything so far and sharing your story with us. This is exactly what we want to do. We want to kind of highlight and let people know about the history and the stories of different Kizomba people, to let people know like, hey, these people all come from like different backgrounds and different reasons and things like that, you know? All right. So my first question of the last questions, what has been your most rewarding experience so far in Kizomba?
Rewarding experience.
Mm-hmm. Like what's the best experience you've had so far?
I think it was the competition in Italy.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was the time that I traveled for the first time alone. Right, it was the first time I traveled by plane. It was the first time then I traveled alone.
Mm.
And I had to face the different culture, it was my first time that I had to use my English mm-hmm. to eat on a daily basis, and also to try my dancing skills.
Yeah, so you get that pressure.
Mm-hmm. And improve, and at the same time I had studying in school and traveling from time to time to Italy. Everything, it was kind of really... It was really exciting, and I think it was the best experience, and I really missed the time. I remember when we took the third place mm-hmm. in the final, and then I left. It was kind of sad for me that it's already the end of this competition.
Mm-hmm. I got you. So that's awesome, because that kind of forced you and pushed you up to a higher level, because there are a lot of new experience. So you got a chance to grow. Okay. So what would you say has been your least favorite experience in Kizomba so far?
Least favorite? Mm-hmm. I think it was... I can't think of anything bad, because every memory of Kizomba was good for me.
Uh-huh. And so I know you said the competition was kind of good but also difficult at the same time. Were there any other, I guess, kind of like struggles or anything you had when you were first starting?
Yes, teaching, that was, as I said before, I was pretty a shy person.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to face that to teach others. Also, at the same time, the other people were they were all older. So the fact that they were taught by a lot younger guy was also different than the usual workshop.
Yeah, for sure.
So I had to handle all this pressure and work on myself to in a like, social way also.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I think I improved a lot thanks to kizomba and thanks to teaching in my social skills,
mm-hmm.
because it forced me to open up myself to people more and to public performances.
Okay, awesome. That's really good because you're just growing more on like a personal level, you know, to achieve higher abilities in the kizomba world, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, last question. What advice would you give to the kizomba dancers of the world today?
Advice? That would be probably to be open-minded to fusions. Because I know that there's now the time that urban kiz is a new thing, is a hype also, and topic, controversial topic.
Yeah, for sure.
Some dancers. Because many people think that the real kizomba is the basis are the kizomba from Angola,
mm-hmm.
and all the fusions and the urban kiz is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that we urban kiz dancers we don't say that the kizomba the real one is wrong. We also I also enjoy dancing kizomba samba mm-hmm. from time to time, but it's good to develop to do like new things.
Mm-hmm.
And urban kiz for me is also way to while I dance urban kiz I can express myself more and express music because I didn't feel that while I was dancing kizomba traditional. Because in urban kiz I can. There's like bigger space, bigger thing that I can use for interpreting like every sound. Like
exactly, musical interpretation.
Musical interpretation. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. All right, Wojtek. Well, those are my last three questions. Thank you so much for taking some time out of your morning, and I know that you're still getting over some illness. So I appreciate you taking some time out to talk with me. At this point, I just like to let people know if they want to hear more about you or find out more about you, where can they reach you?
Facebook will be the simplest way.
Mm-hmm.
I have my personal Facebook, just my name, Wojtek Pazur, and mm-hmm. and I have also a fan page, Wojtek Kiz.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way they can reach me. They can ask me whatever they want. Yeah,
definitely. Okay, I will include those links in the show notes for the people there. Once again, Wojtek, thank you so much for your time, and I wish you the best in your kizomba journey. Hopefully, we'll meet each other one day and share some dances, yeah?
Yeah, hopefully. Thank you so much for inviting me here.
Thank you. Thank you for checking out the Dance Your Heart on Fire podcast today. Be sure to check out neokizomba.com for links to everything that we chatted about today, as well as some awesome free resources to enhance your kizomba journey. Compõe e começa agora é com Kizê. Baby like you. I'm tired of looking for love. My heart just wanna love. Like you. I know that's what you like.